surprised at that. So Kuros Academy not wanting to first pick Thresh. Maybe I want to see if Elise comes through here, because that's to me what shows up now with no bans there. I'm thinking if there's like another really high priority champion, like Elise can already move from Broken Shard. I feel like Determined can ban Elise and they're safe here, but I'm wondering what's going through their minds right now.
Yeah.
Olaf wasn't even played last time.
Yeah. Interesting.
Huh.
The Olaf ban.
So yeah.
Of course they're going to pick Elise.
Yep. Easy Elise
right
pick.
On that one.
Likely Vi for Broken Shards. It's kind of next. Actually, no. Kha'Zix and Gragas, I feel like, both show up here.
I mean, there's a chance that they just want to continue to pick on Rux, and they were expecting Rux to just play that, I suppose. You know, Olaf is actually pretty good going toe-to-toe with Renekton. If Westrise wants to play that again, now, theoretically, he wouldn't have Renekton, but Rux could just pick Renekton here.
Yeah.
And then Westrise would be out of luck.
Shen?
Pretty much. That's what he had to go back to. He could play like Kennen or Warwick or like
some of that in solo queue.
Something like that.
I want to see Kennen come back. Riv would be happy.
Yeah, of course they're going to pick Renekton.
Here we go. So Leona going to grab in, not go for the Annie this time around. They banned the Thresh. So we're going to have something a little bit farther down the tier list here for Sheep.
Well, these things are going better for Curse Academy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Great champion
so far. Olaf ban confusing, Thresh ban strong, Ziggs ban. You look at this, all they did is they banned out three champions Determined used.
Mm-hmm.
So immediately they're throwing them a little bit off kilter.
Yeah.
Their one way of changing the game is to not run the AD carry. We're going to see an AD carry. They pick Leona. They combo that with an AD carry.
Leona Jarvan.
No.
And very unlikely.
Yeah. And that means the other way they could change the game is just by making it so Determined has guaranteed at least 3/5 new picks.
Okay.
And they went for the easier version of changing the game.
Yes. So Caitlyn coming through here, switched their AD carry around, bit safer. Gragas through as well. 10 seconds. They're taking their sweet freaking time with these picks right there. They're Determined, making sure they're doing the right thing. Bubba Dub going to go down to Lulu here. And they are going to actually opt into Mundo versus Renekton top.
Yes.
Huh.
Which I think is totally fine.
Okay.
It means they're going to lose out in lane pressure early, but I think Mundo is one of the better survivalists in the top lane.
Yeah.
He won't necessarily die to Rux's Renekton. Also, I feel like the gauntlet's been dropped here. Determined says Robert X. Lee and Bubba Dub will run Caitlyn Annie.
Oh, man.
And do better.
Yeah?
Is what they're saying. They don't have to play against Thresh, but still.
True.
I think there it's a strong lane right there.
Leona's pretty scary anyway. We'll see what Curse Academy now goes with their AD carry and mid lane slots, most likely, if we kind of believe what everyone else has been running normally. 20 seconds to make their choices here. And I gotta say, Determined's lineup looks strong.
Yes.
Like they've got a good set of champions here. They've got good engage. They've got split pushing. Weaker lanes, as you said, aside from the fact that they've got Annie Caitlyn. Top lane, I guess, mostly is the weaker one. And okay.
Yes.
I like both of these.
I do, but I wouldn't. I would like Yasuo because he is strong, and a little damn strong right now. But he would have no knockup synergy in that fight.
True.
If they would have ran it just him alone, it would have been very difficult for him to get off his combo. So instead, Jaximus goes with what he had medium success with last game.
Okay. Yeah, held the lane pretty much equal against Prolly. This time he's going to be fighting a Gragas instead of a Ziggs. We'll see if that changes much here. Sheep is going to switch over onto Leona now. The Lucian coming in as well. So an entirely new bottom lane here for Curse Academy because Determined just stole theirs.
Yeah, Lucian Lulu is going to try and aggress onto Bubba Dub's Annie. That's the danger in this lane, is if Leona and Lucian can get a little bit ahead, then they take Annie's aggression completely away from her.
Yeah.
No matter how safe Robert X. Lee can stay on Caitlyn, Bubba Dub would just get obliterated on Annie.
Yeah, be pretty rough for him. So now
that
the hover.
Banned last game, too.
Yeah.
Where would you go, friend?
Most likely Broken Shard. Now, Westrise played it, actually in the mid lane, interestingly, in the spring promo tournament.
Yeah. What if they did it mid in Gragas jungle?
Could do that
probably
too.
Not.
Thing is, Prolly's not been playing it that much. This is Broken Shard's most played in solo queue.
Correct. Okay.
He said this is the champion he expected. He said I expect a Ziggs ban. I expect a Kassadin ban in game one. I expect a Kha'Zix ban. So we've seen some of that come back and forth. Of course, the Ziggs ban this time did get through last time around, but this is most likely the way this comes up here, right? Teleport move to top lane.
I agree. That makes the most sense. They have the obvious synergy of Gragas isolating a target for Kha'Zix. But Curse Academy, they have to worry now about what happened to Zuna earlier when he played Kha'Zix. If Chaturas is good enough to mirror Broken Shard wherever he goes, Kha'Zix will not win a duel against Elise.
Yeah.
Cannot get isolations. Elise does more damage early on in the game. Mm-hmm. And Kha'Zix is a gold-reliant jungler who relies on getting kills in order to transition into late game.
Yeah.
Game on, I guess.
Game on. Yeah. See if we can do it. It's going to be a fun one. Game's going to be coming up very, very soon. And, yeah, I'm wondering how that matchup turns out because you've got already the top lane matchup that's going to be weak early on for the tournament. The better early game jungler as well for Curse Academy. So there's two factors there. And I figure you can pick on that. Rux has been probably the most consistent player for Curse Academy so far. And I don't know if Renekton's like a carry per se, but you've got two big factors to say, look, Rux can take over top lane and do some fun things to you guys.
Yeah, Renekton is a carry until about 25 minutes.
Okay.
So once you get past that point, Renekton can become a neutralized factor. So definitely Curse Academy realized what happened to him last game. Mm-hmm. They lost control early on, and they could never get it back.
Yeah.
So immediately in the picks and bans, Leona, Lucian, Renekton, Elise, all these things are saying they are not going to give up control early. If they do, that game is over. They will not be able to come back. But at least they can be in it if they have a better early game.
We'll see what they can do with this one. The game is afoot here, and here we go. Curse Academy on the blue side looking to tie up this best of three at 1-1. Determined already with the lead in games. They win this. They move on to the final four next week. This can do with this one coming down. And another grouped up engage here for the tournament on the bottom side this time.
Yeah, this time they have Bubba Dub with the Annie stun. Maybe looking to make something happen. They actually ping the same brush if you were to flip the map from the last game. This time, instead of a Thresh Hook, they have an Annie stun. But Curse Academy pulling the same set of shenanigans right now.
Actually, Bubba Dub hasn't been casting any spells yet. He might be starting. We see a lot of Annie start Q for the lane against Leona. And the fact that he hasn't been spending mana.
He has full mana.
Yeah.
No stun.
He's not charging Incinerate.
Therefore, that initiate.
What a terribly weakened level one determined.
Well, if they ran into people, they wouldn't be able to do much.
Throw cleavers and barrels at them. They can all press Q.
They would probably body slam, I'd have to say.
Yeah.
Gragas early on in the game.
Yeah.
No longer has reduced damage when you hit multiple targets.
Four of the five could press Q.
Well, everyone could press Q.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like that's like what they would probably put in the team fight.
I could press Q whenever I want.
It's true.
Don't even need a skill in it.
I don't even have a keyboard, but I could press Q. Mm-hmm. Pull up my phone, hit it on the touchscreen. Mm-hmm. Got skills like that. Westrice chilling. He's learned Q. He's got cleavers.
Yep, there you go. Bubba Dub skilling up Q already.
Same for Broken Shard there on Kha'Zix. There's the cleavers from Westrice.
I'd say Q is the most taken ability at level one.
If
you were to average all champions.
Yeah. I think it's by
probably by a very wide margin.
Yeah, I would say more than three quarters.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go, guys. Jaxxmas also with Q. There he is in the mid lane. Probably going to last hit with his... he headbutts half of those minions. Like. Interesting attack animation.
Grog hits with his face. Or his belly.
Yeah. Okay, so blue buff's taken by both junglers. They're going to sweep around to the various sides of the map. Early engage here by Sheep. But goes to half HP for that one. Doran's shield opener, though. Gonna give him some nice regen.
They want level 2. Both of these guys want level 2 as quickly as possible. If Bubba Dub hit level 2, they might get a kill. If Sheep hits level 2 first, they could go and kill Bubba Dub. It all depends on how aggressive they get. But they get a stun!
Ooh, this is not ideal for Bubba Dub. 200 health right there. Fabi chasing on down. Burning down. This poor Annie knows all about fire. It's hurting her a bit.
Wow, so tons of trading going on right there. And if they can withstand a little bit more, Sheep's Doran's shield will regen him much more than Annie's Doran's ring. It ends up that Leona lane gets level 2 first, and that means they can aggress.
And of course, Bubba Dub out of potions as well, but does have Flash and Ignite. We'll see if he keeps getting pressured on right there. Still level 1. Finally, almost. Ooh.
That probably would have killed him if you would have landed that E. So it's a good thing that Sheep missed it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Been a bit risky, but
just a little bit.
So far, these guys are okay. I want to see where this lane keeps going because actually, with all that pushing going on, a lot of minions actually got missed by Fabi, and you have a minion kill lead for Robert X Lee.
Wow. It's always interesting when AD carries value harassment so heavily. If they do not get a kill, it can oftentimes backfire in the smallest of ways.
19 gold worth of backfire. Not the worst in the world. One
depends
extra potion.
Depends on the minion that you miss.
True. Could be 14.
So Kahneman is even more. Tatouris wants to make something happen here. Roberto, X Lee. He's really not in much danger right now.
I feel like he's almost in cocoon range, though.
He is.
They could chain that, but he could flash, I suppose. Jump on a Bubba-Dub, and he does have flash. There comes the attack on in. Half HP there, jumping in from Elise. Good stun, back on a little bear. And it's going to be the Elise running away, taking attacks as she goes. One more auto, 200 health. Wow, Roxy's going for this one. Gets Cocoon in the face, but here comes Broken Shard. Flash EQ. Ooh, flash from T-Tours. Close.
Yeah, I guess that was a flash for Broken Shard. He couldn't expect much more of that. It was a very slow arriving counter gank. And this theoretically means that it's much harder for Elise to defend because she wants to protect her double buffs. Now Determined can push on this, but this is a very dangerous place to be.
Curse Academy, both level 2. No, that's going to be Fabi hitting 3, but low on health. Looks like not too much picked up. Cocoon's going to miss right there. This wave will get cleared out pretty safely. Looks like the minions, though, are going to be much nicer here for Determined. They're pushing another wave. What I'm guessing is a recall because Bubba-Dub's low.
Yeah, what an interesting move here in the bottom lane. They're really pushing aggressively 3v3. Not much is going to happen unless they get engaged on by Curse Academy. So maybe they're daring them to come in, knowing that they have the backup of Westrice if they were to get into a long extended fight.
Yeah, you're right. This is just very strange, though. It's a constant siege, and they're actually forcing Curse Academy to recall. Well, okay, they pushed it and they stopped.
Yeah.
But, like, Curse Academy, their bottom lane is running out of health. We identified it as a pain point last time, and Determined are still working them over in this duo lane.
Yeah, so 25-3 now. This is generally what Caitlyn does to people. Lucian is such a strong laner that he can get. Oh, Bubba-Dub gets
caught. Bubba-Dub not in a good spot. Flash into Fabi. Kill picked up. One more attack. Nope, Robertson is going to stutter step that one. Never mind, there's the turnaround. Curse Academy liking this. And this stun's back up soon for Sheep.
Bubba-Dub overstepped his bounds right there. He should not have been even in range for the Leona EQ there. He thought because he had his flash up that he would be safe, but he was just too low. He got bursted down before his flash would really save him.
And Bubba-Dub didn't even get his ignite out, and I think that might have been enough damage to kill off Fabi for a trade, and just got nothing there. Doran's shield now also picked up for Bubba-Dub. Says, man, took a lot of damage there. Let me try to lower this one next time.
They're going to try and get some revenge back in that lane because they're definitely fighting a lot. Rux, though, up in CS this time. He lost by 110 to Westrice if we count the end of the game last time. Obviously, not all of that is his fault because the lane kind of broke down at some point. Definitely gets level 6 first. Looks to continue pressuring.
And a 7 minion kill lead as it goes into the turret. Fabi has recalled first for a Vamp Scepter. Those Zerk Greaves here for Robert X Lee. So early attack speed and movement speed. Going to try to continue to abuse the range advantage here to determine duo lane.
Yeah, we consider that Fabi just got the assist for that first blood. 200 gold instead of 400. It doesn't put him far ahead of Robert X Lee. So Robert X Lee can continue to be fairly aggressive in this lane, despite the death they took.
So here we go. Back under the turret they are again. Bubba Dub, Robert X Lee. Level 4 on all sides. Very deep engage here by Sheep. Going in towards Annie. Good damage there. Bubba Dub taking the pain. Storm Shield helping him a bit, as does the Molten Shield.
Yeah, that's one of the most underrated parts about the Annie lane, is when she gets Molten Shield, how resilient she actually is when you try and go aggressive on her. Starting with double Doran's items just increases that health pool even more.
Working pretty nicely.
As long as he stops getting caught by the owner.
Well, yeah, at least he regen back up, but is again out of items entirely.
Yeah.
This Determined bottom lane really only has trinkets now for them. And I feel like we're going to see T-Tours come back at some point. He is on Elise. 27 minions. Only really, one gank we've seen so far. And was stuck in the bottom lane for a while.
Yeah, that ended up with a very long siege and counter siege by both these guys. I wonder. So much action has been focused on the bottom lane this match. Because really, Determined were to take control of this. It bleeds very easily into the rest of the game with Dragon control, and considering the other lanes are mostly focused around farming at the moment.
Yeah, and actually you kind of talked about the other lanes. The top lane is the one that's actually doing quite nicely, right? Rux got a much better lane. He got a Renekton here, and he's really pushing around Westrice. He's up 12 minions, which is a pretty appreciable score for this state of the game. You're seeing Westrice have to give him the space. He's got to throw Cleavers to last hit. Mm-hmm. Rux haven't even had to use a potion yet to regen. Pretty solid there.
Yeah, neither of them has had to shop yet. They're basically just playing that farm game. Westrice is going to want to shop before he transitions to a dragon fight. I think that's going to be Westrice's attempt to get back in this game. Some slick moves by Jaxxmas, but he gets ulted.
Doesn't put him in a turret range. A little bit of damage coming across. Probably Sting in this battle, actually. Just not even afraid. Doesn't even take much damage from Death.
Flash body
Jaxxmas low.
No.
Ignite is on. Timed out just now.
Yeah, he ignited early. If Jaxxmas wouldn't have flashed away so early, probably would have finished with a flash body slam.
Well, still winning the trade. Pretty nice stuff here. Sheep going back in. There's the Cullen. Good damage across the side towards Determined, but Robert actually on that long range Caitlyn, forcing him back down.
These guys are fighting a lot.
Yeah.
Broken Shard trying to come down with the gank here. He hasn't been able to make much happen on Kha'Zix, and he kind of needs to. I remember after the game we were talking to one of the pros. Kha'Zix is so successful, these guys get so confident on him in solo queue because they can pick up kills everywhere, get really farmed. Kha'Zix is so good at fighting people. But unless you're forcing fights in a competitive challenger or pro game, he's not as effective.
Yeah.
He farms at an average pace. And that's really what Broken Shard has been in this game. It's very, very average. Lee Sin was much more impressive, so good ban by Curse Academy.
Very well chosen there. And of course, the Elise first pick as well. Just had to guarantee that happened with all the jungle bans that were there. You're like, yeah, expecting to see the Elise come through. That did happen here. Sheep and Fabi have swept away the wards, so they could sneak the Elise into this brush here. As long as they keep track of the wards coming down. There's a stun on above, but the jump in, coming in through. Half HP now on the Annie. Good, Timber's going to stop to dive on in. And here comes the re-engage. Broken Shard is here.
There's Mundo.
Coming across. Mundo going to try to teleport, and he does make it here. Low on health.
Oh, no.
Going to get attacked on Force of Flashway. Picked up there. Two kills now. For Curse Academy, the Chaser coming through, finds Robert X Lee, forced a barrier. Stewarding away, Sheep very low, forced out. Flash out from Determined. Fabi not going to find more, but Jaxmas is here with the ultimate.
Oh dear, he's coming in hot.
What's he going to find? There's a jump on in. Broken Shard going to drop down. Robert X Lee, will he find enough damage though? Ulti, not quite enough. 180 health left onto Zed. 3-0 Curse Academy.
So much action right there, and it all goes in Curse Academy's favor, Freak. Really, though, Westrice's teleport was destroyed by Rux and Sheep. So first off, Rux got as much damage as he could down on Westrice. He actually ignited him before he got there. Then when Westrice did pop his ultimate, the ignite and most importantly healing debuff was continued because Sheep then used his ignite on Leona at the same time. So Westrice really just came in to die, and everything backfired for Determined.
Lost a whole hell of a lot of minions there in the top lane. 23 minions now, Rux's lead, as well as a level and most of that turret health. So this lane has really turned sour. The adaptations by Curse Academy, I gotta say, are working. That top lane, just it's a big factor here. It really is.
Yep.
Rux even got an assist for that one. He had dealt damage recently enough.
Yeah, he ignited him right as Westrise went down,
yep,
and they killed him so quickly. So bonuses all around for Curse Academy. One thing that did happen, though, in all that action, has probably got a bit more ahead of Jaxmas. Jaxmas roamed down, probably continued to farm. Prawley's going to want to turn this back around. There's still only 1,000 gold separating these two teams because the farm has generally been on the side of Determined. Robert has farmed much better than Fabi. Prawley farmed much better than Jaxmas, and that's making up for the top lane discrepancy.
He's doing a good job of this one right here. Curse Academy, 1,300 gold in the lead. I want to see what they go with this one. They didn't turn the bottom lane victory into much. Their health bars were low, so no turret, no dragon, no nothing. But the dive in again onto Bubba Dub. This Annie taking a bunch of pain, staying in the fight. They turn back onto Fabi. Look at the burst damage coming across. They will trade kills. Robert X Lee, 300 gold. Broken Shard finding Zed in the mid lane as well. Nice pickup there. Probably helping with that one. Things turning back around for Determined.
Yeah, that's one of the fears when Annie gets a little bit stronger, even if they can close on him to get him. But this mid lane fight's even more important. We're going to have to figure out what happened here because we didn't catch it initially. Let's see what Broken Shard does. He evolves his wings first to close on a Jaxamist and really just bursts him down from really far away. Those are the fights that Kha'Zix kind of lives for, is just anyone fighting in the map helps Kha'Zix because he's very good at closing out and finishing kills.
Yep, and he did show up there. So the spirit items, the tier 3 spirit items, I guess. I forget what to call them, like, on aggregate. The Ancient Golem, the Elder Lizard.
I think we could say the jungle items.
The jungle items?
I think that
completed.
Would
okay.
The big ticket jungle items.
The big ticket jungle
Wriggle's
items.
Wriggle's Lantern is not one of those items right now.
Oracle's Elixir and Boots Mobility. The Season 2 big ticket jungle items.
Yeah, that happened immediately.
Zero combat stats. Ugh. All right, we're here with actual stats, though. Boots of Speed done on T-Tours as well. These guys happy to keep themselves in decent shape. And of course, Determined now only 400 gold away. T-Tours, showing up for Westrise. A lot of burst on the Mundo, and
ooh,
goodbye. Pretty easy escape. 800 gold now, putting Curse Academy in the lead. These guys have had a much, much better early game. Poor Mundo's having a rough time. Turret goes down. Even more gold. 1,500.
Yeah,
never
Westrise,
keeps climbing.
Westrise is definitely getting picked on a little bit in this game.
Yeah, okay, so we're going to see just control.
Got
control
a quick pause
now
coming
Curse Academy. Yeah,
unfortunately,
quick pause.
Yeah.
Not a problem.
Yeah, I got to say, so Curse Academy, thus far done a good job controlling the early game. I mean, I think Leonel is basically used on recharge in the bottom lane. Mm-hmm. They're trying to keep Robert X Lee down. He's still getting his farm.
Yeah.
And he's still getting kills, which is a little bit worrisome.
And he's not the one dying
yeah.
either.
Yeah, exactly.
So he's getting experience as well. Yeah.
Exactly. And he tends to die a lot just by nature of the way people play her.
Yeah.
So those deaths aren't costing them much as long as they're getting the return kills on Robert.
And that's the funny thing as well is the change made in the 2014 season where if you kill minions, your death streak rolls back. Every 1,000 gold from minions is one less death as far as bounty goes.
Yeah.
But Annie's not getting gold from minions.
No. But if she gets the assist,
sure.
It still rolls it back the equivalent of one death.
Yeah, per assist. So depending on the assist, and of course she got one in that last fight, of course they turned the kill back around, mm-hmm. so that would have rolled one back. But I'm just kind of wondering, like...
how much is Annie worth?
Yeah. Still in the 200s, the high 200s. I think it's like 0-2-1 or 0-3-2, something like that, so not that bad. But, you know, for what it's worth, compared to if Robert X Lee had been dying, right, the AD carry still has time in lane, mm-hmm. right, still has time to get experience, and so the Caitlyn is scaling quite nicely, and that was always a big problem. Less dominant, but still important. Of course, the dual lane for Curse Academy working much better to overall. They're getting kills into Fabi. He's doing well. They've got farm. They didn't lose their turret. They're not getting camped that badly. So a lot of things definitely going differently.
Yeah. I'm really wondering how Broken Shards Kha'Zix is going to come in. Mm-hmm. Because he's actually been able to pick up a kill.
Yeah.
You know, evolved the wings first. So he's going to be starting the go around now. Mm-hmm. And I think it's going to be whether Broken Shard and Prawly can stop or at least equalize this game right now from Curse Academy. I think it's going to be like Rux and Chachuras on Redaction and Elise.
Yeah.
Until about 25 minutes, trying to make plays. And if they don't have a lead, I'm going to say of at least 5,000 gold by that point, I think Determined Gaming would win.
Really?
Only because Caitlyn is farming better than Lucian, and I think Kha'Zix and Gragas are going to be powerful enough, and Mundo as well, will no longer be able to get killed against Renekton. So that's those are my boundaries I'm putting up in this game. 5,000 gold by 25 minutes or Determined wins.
Okay.
We'll see what happens.
Okay. And I guess the odds would go like up and down.
Yeah.
Because that's like an 80% Determined wins, not like 100%.
Yeah.
So it's like if it's 6,000, it's even less likely. If it's 3,000, it's even more likely.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Right, I'm doing like the
Curse
odds
Academy
thing.
Is 6,000 up at 25 minutes. They're going to win.
Even higher.
They're going to win.
Likelihood. Okay.
That's the break point.
I mean, I feel like almost any team that has 6,000 at that point is like ridiculously far ahead.
Yeah, well, we have 11 minutes to find out.
Let's see what happens.
Yeah.
Here we go. I predict a 20-minute surrender. I don't really.
That's not going to happen for you.
No, almost definitely not. This is not Cloud9 making their way into the LCS where they were ridiculously dominant. Determined Gaming here. Okay, salvaging a 1,700 gold deficit so far. Mid lane. Up 50 minions, and assist there on Prawly as well. Did, in fact, go for the Seeker's Arm Guard here. So different build now that he's Gragas. Not going for the tier option.
Using that a little bit against Zed. I think he might sit on the Seekers for a while. Mm-hmm. And just go Deathcap next. Otherwise, his barrels are not going to have enough oomph that he really needs.
Yeah. Oomph is very important on Gragas. We'll see if he can get some more of that in this game.
Oomph is important in general for League of Legends, I think.
Yeah. What if... Do you like... Zero AP Janna's have oomph just because, like, the ultimate knockback?
I'm going
to
say no.
Is that oomph enough?
No, I feel like oomph is more of a damaging statistic, not a healing statistic. They got to watch out for Elise and Leona here.
Here we go. Let's see. Sheep looking forward. Of course, people standing on wards are going to run away from this one. Dragon flapping his wings happily. Westry still getting pushed around, although for all the pain and suffering, he's not continuing to hemorrhage minions that badly still.
No.
Well, I mean, it's down to 30 now. I guess it's
losing
actually
his turret is pretty rough, too. Surprisingly, he's not really going to be able to go where he pleases if he doesn't buy boots anytime soon.
It's true.
He's been trying so desperately to just stay alive against Renekton that he hasn't worried about movement speed, which means if he potentially teleports down, like, he's not a real threat. He's just going to be a very slow-moving monster man.
Yeah, he has to land every cleaver to, like, keep up with you there.
Yeah, just to be able to land the next one. Like, I don't think he'd actually close into auto-attack range.
Oh, dear. So, Fabi, gonna sweep away the wards of the dragon under control now a little bit by Curse Academy, but they relinquish the control right there. Coming back over, pink ward's there. Teleport is up for Westrice.
This is exactly, though, what a level 11 Renekton wants to do. Dominus is so strong for him right now. The Determined Gaming, even if they fight, this is going to be incredibly dangerous.
God, are you serious? He got it. Well, that's embarrassing.
Yeah, it really is. And that is disastrous for Curse Academy. That means the gold lead is basically gone for them right now. Westrise did not even have to use his teleport to get down there. What a swing just by Robert XE throwing in a Piltover Peacemaker.
Well, he's going to get jumped on. Actually whiffs his 90 caliber net because of the root right there. Not going to get much for it. Timbers comes down on a sheep. Broken Red shows up. Damage up with there. Misses the W. Ulti come in. Nice block by Fabby. And there's the kill on Robert XE. So far, a good start for Curse Academy, actually. One for nothing. Tidra was jumped on. Coming back in is Sheep, and that's going to be actually the kill, though. Another one for Broken Shard. Look at the damage output there.
Him?
Are you serious? Broken Shard, triple kill, and Jacksmith says no.
Gets 500 gold on the shutdown side. But anyway, the game just broke wide open, Freak, because after the Dragon Steal, chaos broke out. Rux actually rotated down to the bottom. Zed's not stopping.
Thumbina puts on the shield, but that might not be enough. Jacksmith picks up the kill, jumps back to his ult clone way over there. Look how far he went.
Prawly actually hit him with the barrel, I think. Because Prawly threw a barrel backwards at where Zed's clone was going to be, and as soon as he poured out, I think he hit him. But he wasn't able to finish off with the flash body slam because Jacksmith flashed away.
That was pretty freaking cool, though. I like
really
that
cool
one quite a bit.
Sequence of events, I would have to say.
Yeah, he's like off screen, and we're like, that was a clone. That was pretty fun.
Got Westrise, all excited about that one.
I like those moves. We talked about how fun Zed was going to be, and it came through.
It did. He went back after a fight. Westrise, despite being very slow, was able to come in. All right, let's see what actually happened here. So Broken Shard is just looking for resets, which is why he goes in so heavily onto Sheep. But Chaturas came in at just the right time, and since Robert XE was channeling, he just got destroyed. At this point, though, Westrise is only here to tank the turrets. It doesn't matter that he can't really close onto people. Broken Shard gets one, two, and then because he used his leap for the damage, he was able to finish off Fabby and pick up the triple kill. That is fantastic for Determined, even if Jaximus ends up taking the kill.
Yeah, so we're going to be happy with this one. 8-5 now in kills, a 400 gold lead. So a small lead still here for Curse Academy. I know they wish it were higher. We'll see how this one pans out. Minions still getting swept away. These guys go back to business as usual on their lanes. Gold for 10 items are picked up here by both supports, both going for the Talisman of Ascension line. Mm-hmm. That'll be fun to watch for. Of course, they have wards as well in their inventories. And we're now 7 minutes away from the cutoff, Jat.
We are. It's anticlimactic for the beard. No, I'm just kidding. I have no idea if that's going to ring true or not. But the Tiamat on Broken Shard is exactly what he wants to be able to get to. The fact that he was able to pick up four kills by the 18-minute mark means he will absolutely have an impact later on in this game. Fight-reliant Kha'Zix that people fear has arrived for Determined right now. So even though it is a high-tier competitive game we're playing here in the Challenger Series, it's happened for Broken Shard. He found his kills, and he is now dangerous.
Did you know? So you can use both the Q and the Tiamat active while in the air as Kha'Zix.
I did know.
Yeah.
Is
can't use the W anymore.
Yeah, that was changed.
But you have some pretty
here could be a fight. It's very dangerous for Broken Shard.
Stun on the Broken Shard. Stun again on the Broken Shard. And the knockbacks. And Broken Shard does go down. Fabby picking up that kill. Nice and happy for him. 2-2-5 here on this Lucian.
Yeah, Curse Academy really trying to just invade Determined. They know that they are kind of up against the clock right here. Robert XE was in the bottom lane. It was a nice catch on a Broken Shard because he was just foolish to go in there by himself. There's no ward control in their jungle either. So that is one of the reasons they could pick him up. They want more, though.
Yes, they do want more. Of course, Curse Academy, clock ticker for these guys. They do have an early game team composition. To be completely serious about this one, they are going to have a rougher time in the late game if things go equal. Sheep going to look for Robert XE. Can he play around it? That's going to be a root. There's a stun as well.
He's got to get his, he wants a 90 caliber net and get the slow, but he couldn't get ahead of Sheep. Doesn't matter.
Yeah, he's all right. Gets to the turret, or at least, yeah, an actual standing turret there. Not too bad. Prawly and Bubba Dub actually just get control over mid lane and take a turret down without answer. So 2-2 in the turret game, and the minions are, or the gold, I should say, is equal for these guys.
Yeah. Great comeback, in a sense, from Determined Gaming.
Yeah.
They weren't down much, but they were definitely losing some of the lanes. You can even see just the farm on Westrise now. It's right back where it needs to be against Rux. He's gotten a few easy waves. He got some of the assists in the bottom lane when Broken Shard was down jumping all over the place. And Prawly continued to farm. I mean, look at that differential he has against Jaximus. Jaximus has gotten the kills, but Prawly has made up for it in minions.
Good stuff right here. Yeah, 70.
He's got
you
more
can see,
gold.
Yeah, more gold overall. I guess, what, they're up a dragon. So,
yeah, that's only it's only about 130 or 40, depending on when the dragon was taken.
Yeah. Here we go. Rux sweeping away top lane minions. He is level 14. highest, higher than anyone undetermined, highest in the game overall. So Rux is like the sole like continuing to work factor here for the team. He's the best performing, at least compared to his opponents as well. But you kind of talked about until 25 minutes, Renekton stops being that carry. Jackson is looking out for the bottom lane. 3 versus 1. Robert forced to run away. Here comes the broken shard, though. Not much of a stun, actually, onto Kaylin. And Robert's going to be fine here. Jump in from Zed. Damage still coming across vertically. Bunch of pain, but exploded there by Bubba Dub.
And Prawly wants to go. No, what? He's just messing around.
All right.
It's like a frustration barrel right there by Prawly. He's going to want it back.
Wow, the jump's still in the knockback. Good rappel. Yeah, good jump over to the side there. Misses the flash, not a good thing. That'll be a kill. Prawly picks that one up. 7-9 now. Determined still on the chase. Sheep, not in a good spot. One more Q will do it. That's a kill picked up by Broken Shard. 8-9. Determined really getting back into this one.
Did that wall get thicker or something? We've seen 2 failed flashes over a similar wall in this matchup. One by Westrice there, one by Chaturis. He was panicking while he was trying to run away. He had dodged so much, too.
Yeah.
He did a really great job with his rappel dodging all of Prawly's damage, but still fell short.
And now Determined capitalizing on those kills right there, taking the secondary bottom lane turret there. 35,000 to 33,000 gold. Determined now in control of this one.
Yeah.
And they scale well. These guys are looking a lot better now.
Yeah, Jaximus overcommitted for that one. And it cost them more than just a couple kills because the timing was awful. Being able to get Dragon after this for Determined is absolutely huge. And the worst part of all of this is the strongest person on Curse Academy's team is Rux. And they're not using Rux to try and make their plays right now. They need to.
He's sitting there trading farm and not even trading well. 225 to 207. Westrice is actually catching up in this matchup. Back to level 14, equal in levels as well. With really no intervention, I don't feel like I've seen a gank for Westrice. He's just slowly clawing his way back in. Lost his turret, to be fair, but like in that one-on-one, it's like, yeah, okay, he's holding on.
This is looking really grim right now. We're thinking by 25 minutes, if Curse Academy had a 5,000 gold lead, otherwise they lose. They got to be worried about being 5,000 gold in the hole by that point, if Determined Gaming keeps up what they're doing right now. Prawly did go for the Zhonya's, so he's lacking a bit of that oomph from his barrels, but he'll get the death cap pretty soon. He's already sitting on a Needless Healer draw.
It's true. He can at least neutralize the oomph from Zed by Zhonya-zing when the active comes through, so we'll see how well he holds up in these fights. Of course, he's really been just kind of displacing enemy champions anyway. He's got damage coming through from Broken Shard and Robotics Lee anyway.
Yeah, and he's the one picking up the garbage waves too. 248 farm now. It's impossible for Jaximus to keep pace because Prawly is literally just running from lane to lane and power clearing with Gragas.
So, bunch of money coming into his pockets. Gragas able to afford a whole bunch more items. And as we scale into the late game, Broken Shard also taxing a little bit. Using his team hat to guarantee some of these.
Want to catch.
Gets spotted. Timbers comes down, but no stun. There's a stun from Bubba Dub. More damage coming through. Is it going to be enough? That's going to be enough. Kill picked up by Robin X Lee. And they got control over mid.
Just a clean kill. You know, I expect Bubba Dub to actually have the stun charge, but he gets away with it anyway. Stuns with his Q. And now the risk of a counter initiation is much lower from Curse Academy. Nice kill. Nice turret take.
Now, great stuff for these guys. And again, now blue buff under control. That's going to be going in pretty easily to determine. Smited away by Broken Shard. Everything just turned on its head as of about 5 minutes ago, and all of this is going very nicely for the squad.
Yeah, pink wards have been able to be cleared out as well. Determine's going to sweep around and I think take more of these turrets because they've clearly shown now they can be the superior team in team fights. And Curse Academy is, you know, getting caught out in rotations. Determine is moving better and faster.
Ooh, they're setting up a trap in this river brush. I'm surprised this is the choice right here, but Curse Academy are nearby. They show back up there, kill the minion wave, and now Fabi's got to be careful. Rux there as well. Jaximus alone split pushing bottom, so 5v4 here.
Yeah, they got to watch out that they don't lose 2 turrets here if they lose this fight.
Bit of a knockback onto some of the members there. Sheep's going to go in onto Westrace. Not the target you want to go for. Stun there on Robert X Lee, slow it above it up. The fight has begun. 5 versus 4. Kaylin forced backwards. Jaximus kills the turret on the other side, but the chase has begun. There's the kill off. 1 for 1 so far in this battle. Rux falls down, making it 2 for 1. Curse Academy now stuck under the turret. 3 for 1. Double kill for Broken Shard. Still chasing on down. Can they find Sheep?
Yep.
Going to be one more. Triple kill again. 8-3-2 on Jungle Kha'Zix. That's why they picked it.
And it just cost them their AD carry. Yes, Jaximus could get 2 turrets on the other side, but Determined should be able to answer with just as many turrets if they decide to continue this push. They actually don't. They're content with taking just the 4 and getting Jaximus out of there. I still like that move by Determined, getting that many kills onto Broken Shard.
Yeah. Well, plus three kills overall on the fight, and actually probably still going to push a little bit here.
Yeah,
they might just get this one. No one's really coming in that quickly. So overall, plus three kill trade. A lot of them going on to the increasingly fed Kha'Zix. Hex Drinker on that champion.
Yep.
Trigger goes down. A lot of control now. Determined up, as you said, 5,000 gold they are. Dude, actually, no, 7,000 gold. This is getting bigger and bigger for these guys, and you're seeing 9 to 10,000 gold on everyone down the line, top jungle, mid AD.
Yeah, and the impressive thing there is the 9,800 gold by Kha'Zix. Mm-hmm. He has turned himself into a legitimate farmed Kha'Zix. He has more gold than his AD carry, so everyone needs to be fearful. Pretty full damage item build there, too.
Yeah, completed Last Whisper. Just got added after that last fight. Pretty happy stuff.
Yeah, Death Cap on a Prawly as well. That means they just have the Giant Tank and Westrise. This is like the perfect prototypical team comp they have. They got the Westrise who can go in and take all the hits.
Yeah.
They have Robert X. Lee who can kind of deal with the tanks in the back line. Prawly to displace everyone and get them low. And then the really strong AD Assassin to kind of finish them off.
Yeah.
Obviously, that's not too short Bubba Dub, but he doesn't do as much damage. He just kind of locks him down. Like, this is what...
He gets him in.
It's such a versatile team fight composition.
It is.
Because they can disengage, they can engage, they can tank, they can siege, they can do everything they want. Mm-hmm. It's just a matter of them getting out of that laning phase and making it to this part in the game.
And they did. They clawed their way through, they held on, had a couple of really good fights, and here they are. And what's funny to me about Westrise as well is that he didn't even have to, even though you love Spirit Visage on Mundo, didn't even have to buy it because there's not much magic damage on the Curse Academy team.
Exactly. The biggest threat is Elise, who, you know, wasn't really messing with Westrise too much outside of those few early kills.
Yeah. So, Determined, looking to group up. 40 seconds until Dragon. They might put that on their plate right here. They do have all six Tier 1 and Tier 2 turrets already taken down. Westrise trading blows with Rux. Not taking much damage, though. He's got, like, 300 armor. Not very scary.
Not anymore.
Nope.
It took him a while to get to this point. Westrise was getting bullied.
Yeah.
Very heavily by Rux. Determined Gaming seems to have done what Curse Academy could not so far. Determined was losing the early game, but they were able to turn this one around, and they got a pretty commanding advantage right here.
Good stuff by these guys. So here we go. Back to the split push. Westrise has teleport. Probably going to hold on to these waves up top for now. The rest of the team near the mid lane. Dragon is up now. Broken Shard will solo that. Envision of a Ward. That might be just safe enough for him.
I think so, too. He kills it so fast. Kha'Zix with the isolated Q especially.
Jeez. Those are like one-third and died to Q smite.
We've actually been seeing a lot of jungle Kha'Zix's max E second.
Yeah.
Broken Shard's not one of those people.
Nope.
He max W second. But because you're getting the resets on your jump anyways, why not just have that jump do more damage?
Yeah.
It is a interesting thing to consider if you are a Kha'Zix player.
I know Alex did it when he played Kha'Zix most recently in the LCS.
Yeah, maybe it's more of a mid lane Kha'Zix thing.
Maybe.
Because the jungle Kha'Zix is going to want that W to clear jungle a little bit faster. Mm-hmm. Obviously, he's not having much trouble now that he's got his TM out, but I can see it having a bit of a speed increase.
I can see it too.
Plus, you get more healing from your W if you rank it higher. So it's probably a lane Kha'Zix thing.
We'll see where they go. 3 points in E now, Broken Shard. Level 15. Killing off the jungle, and he just does it so easily now at this point. Just the
especially
white camp.
The white.
Yeah. Dies in two Qs. So it's been about 5 seconds that camp goes down. Even has 25 CDR on items in that build, so he can like spam really easily. Infinite mana with the Elder Lizard in the jungle. Pretty happy stuff. Determined are going to play this one slow.
Yeah.
Mudo stay in bottom.
This is similar to the situation they were in the last game. It's a little later in the game. They got a bit less of an advantage. But Determined Gaming didn't actually show the best knowledge of how to finish the game. They just kind of all ran to Baron and decided to do it really fast. And ended up fighting for it. We might see a similar thing this game. They have very good Baron secure once again. Mm-hmm. Gragas ultimate if they wanted to. Broken Shard with Kha'Zix can combo a lot of execute damage. And this time they also have Teleport on Westrise, who should be able to split push on a very tanky Mundo and maybe force a 5v4 at the Baron. But even so, they're definitely looking to Baron to make this their next move. They just didn't do it super cleanly in the first one.
Oh, Determined back to four sweepers, though. They're definitely trying to control the vision.
And I think they'll control the vision fairly well.
Yeah.
It's just a matter of if they can catch a fight without just outright trying to kill the Baron.
And, of course, the wards just went right back down. Like, they just swept around Baron, and there's four wards on the route up. Yeah. So, Curse Academy still got plenty of vision here. Nothing going to get snuck on them. Jacksmith's looking to stop a split pusher. Probably goes for the bait.
Whoa.
But the whole team is there. This is risky. They can catch him.
Yeah, Broken Shard's got to watch out not to get blown up himself when he goes in for this, but gets a lot of burst damage down. Playing it safe. They go in.
A lot of damage. Goodbye to Elise. The Zed's going to go in onto Bubba Dub. Not sure if he's going to get the kill for this one. Close and dies to Ignite, but they trade the kill regardless. 2-for-1. Westrise still bottom.
Yep, Bubba Dub did lock up Tatures right there on Elise. Name is messing me up, Freak. And now they're
Little
just
bear.
Going on to this Baron. There's no smite that would be able to be stolen, and Mundo can teleport in. It's a very difficult defense for Curse Academy.
All right, ult comes in. Sheep wants to stop this one. Jumps in on a Broken Shard. Good damage, actually. Baron helping with this fight. Broken Shard forces a jump away. Ignite is on.
Ooh, no.
Last tick survives with nothing left. Fabby on the chase. Not
Broken
find
Shard
him.
Needs to technically smite this if they want to secure it.
Oh my gosh, he gets it. The smite helping to heal him does drop down to Renekton.
Rux did have an ignite on him though, but yep. Determined secures it. They get the cleaver.
All right, Rux, you've got to try to run for this one. Pops the ulti, not likely to go many places. Damage on Robert X Lee. Forced around again, will fall down. Kill picked up by Caitlyn. This makes it another good fight. Another 2-for-1 overall.
Yeah, and more gold going down onto Determined. They still get the Baron buff on the majority of their team. Caitlyn is alive. Gragas is alive. They want to push this turret now.
Leona will respawn here. 4 versus 4. Like, she makes that 4 versus 3, and he's still around on the other side. Determined starting the siege with the first 3 members of them.
Yeah, Westrise can take turret shots without almost any repercussions. The amount of regen he gets with Baron is just absurd.
Well, there's the CC stack stun into Cocoon, but not going to make him go down. Kayla coming back in to shoot this turret down. 3 shots till it goes. And, ooh, stunned up, though. Here comes the counterattack jumping on in. Crawley dropped the half HP. Jaxmas into the back lines as well. Can he do enough damage? Yes, he pops Robert X Lee, but they trade AD carries. Crawley going to go into the fight. Drops as well. Another 2-for-2 in this battle. These guys trading blows back and forth. Westrise a little bit overcommitted. Jaxmas finds it. Picks up the kill. Titor's killing that bear. Says Little Bear is better than the big one. He's going to be safe with this one here.
Aha.
Chris Academy holding on.
Yeah, good one there.
Stuck
that one in. At this point, we actually got to see them fight one more time. Robert actually got caught just by Leona ult. It wasn't the cleanest fight by Determined. They probably shouldn't have went in on this because they just didn't have the people. Once Caitlyn went down, Westrise was really all on his own as far as damage goes, and probably had no escapes left once he came out of Zhonya, so it allows Jaxinus and Jaturas to just clean up a little bit with double kills. Still not out of the woods yet.
No.
They did save their inhibitors, but it gets Baron buff off Determined.
Well, 10,000 gold up, putting these guys ahead, and Jaximus, I gotta say, 6-3-2 on Zed. That repeat pick has worked for him. Probably did stall him out in the first game, but this time around, he's having a better impact. Broken Shard evolving his ultimate for his last one.
Yeah, he's just gotta jump away from Jaximus.
He's safe.
We're just about his time. Mm-hmm. Be a little careful there.
You know what's kind of interesting?
312 attack damage. That's
yeah.
Scary.
Pretty scary. One thing I kind of enjoy about this matchup right here is we've got the 2 big AD assassins of Season 3, Zed and Kha'Zix, and
yes.
We've moved one to the jungle, and he's been completely successful.
Yeah.
Like, I know, like, every season we're like, okay, the jungle's going to do better, they're going to get more gold, they're going to be a real factor in the game. And we got closer every season, and here we're like, legitimate jungle carry.
Oh, Jaximus.
Like, more and more people put damage in that role.
Speaking of assassins.
Yeah, right? That'd be a crazy fight.
No, I agree. I think a lot of it has to do with the spirit of the Lizard Elf with jungle life. There it comes. Stun's going to land, though.
All right. A lot of burst back on Jaximus. Immediately pops ulti to jump away. Bubba Dub still in the chase. Bloodthirsty support forces a flash away from the mid laner. Good job, Bubba Dub.
Yeah, Broken Shard might want to have continued that one, but you know they ended up burning the Tibbers away from Broken Shard. So since Jaximus didn't die, I'd actually say that is a successful flank as long as he goes back to base, which he is. He has Homeguard boots. He can make it back.
Tibbers being used to tank the
look at that healing,
though. Oh, yeah.
That's because of the Lizard Elder. He's doing so much damage that he just goes into the jungle and heals. Obviously, he's got lifesteal from his Hydra as well, but holy crap.
Yeah, pretty scary guy. GA going to be coming up probably for the last item there for Broken Shard. And Determined Gaming now sitting here, 13,000 gold up. And you got to think they're thinking about closing the game out right here. They're definitely in the lead. Yeah. They definitely have the tools to win the game. They all go top lane for now.
They might be waiting on the next Baron Freak. They're going to try and siege up this bottom turret a little bit. If Prawley can find a good barrel, I think they could go for the win. But they may be a little bit more passive for this. Bubba Dub has no Tibbers. When his flash Tibbers is up, I can see them going all in. But right now, I think they're taking pot shots.
Robert S. Lee forced to cleanse backwards and run. Westrise in the front line, down half HP, getting ignited as well. Rux in the front as well. Decent ulti in from probably the backline, getting dive right here. Jaxmas about to go down. Broken Shard finds it, picks up one kill. Hexbreaker pop, re-engage in from Bubba Dub Sheep, goes down. Max rank WT Druids gets the GA pop, but goes down to a Caitlyn Ace in the hole. And Bubba Dub overcommitted. Rux doing so much damage to this back line right here. Broken Shard is battling him toe-to-toe and life-stealing and winning, arguably. The team now showing up. Assassination comes down. Rux drops. Only Fabi is left alive.
At that point, Curse Academy realized they were getting sieged out slowly. They tried to all-in while the Tippers were down. It was a last-ditch effort, and it didn't work.
30 seconds for the first respawn to come in. Fabi forced to open the gates here for the Tormund. They're going to be taking down turret number one. Almost taking down Fabi. Turret number two as well, but this will be a 2-0. Determined Gaming making the top four.
2-0 against Curse Academy. The second game was much closer. You could see Curse Academy made a pretty good adjustment in between games one and two, but it is Determined Gaming with their experience now. Some veterans on that team like Westrice just coming out on top, laning phase, mid-game, late-game. They showed they can do all of it.
Yep, their players making good plays, even coming back from deficits, getting caught out, dying, still finding things to do, still finding ways to get back into the game. Their shot culling as well.
Yeah.
Kept themselves up there, didn't lose many turrets, capitalized on the kills they did get. Determined looking good.
Yeah, Determined now moves on to the round of four.
Yep.
They're still awaiting their opponent. That game is going to be
played
tomorrow night, so you can find out who they get to play next. Mm-hmm. And I'm looking forward to this final four of the Challenger Series. We got some really quality teams that are going to be coming up against each other.
Yeah. A lot of great familiar players, a lot of good things going to happen. It's going to be a fun one. Now, guys, now that tonight's final Nexus has fallen and tonight's quarterfinal series is in our match history, let's take a look.